I have shared with you previously my bias and strong feelings that breast MRI has a very important role in the evaluation of newly diagnosed patients with breast cancer. I've also previously shared with you that there are certainly two camps and we're fighting over this, and I won't get into those arguments and discussions at all. We received a question at Breast Cancer Answers about, gee, I had my breast MRI, what's next? Well, without any details about the source of this question or where the breast MRI has been done as part of the evaluation, I can give a pretty global answer to this sort of question. First of all, most insurance companies won't even approve breast MRI unless you've got a core biopsy diagnosis of breast cancer. The main indications, I think, for breast MRI are to look for what's called multifocal and multicentric disease, and I believe I've explained the difference between those two with an earlier video answer. Extent of disease is important to us. And I've also shared in another video, when it comes to nipple-sparing mastectomies, breast MRI is quite helpful to us in knowing that the nipple or areolar area is not involved with the cancer. So typically, the breast MRI is done after the digital mammograms, typically after the ultrasound, and clearly after you have an established diagnosis of breast cancer. So what's next, frankly, depends on the results of the breast MRI. I don't know the exact number, but roughly probably about 15% of the time, additional biopsies may be needed. There's a second or third suspicious area that may require either a second look ultrasound to see if something's there and possible additional biopsies. Or in my practice, if we don't see anything on second look ultrasound, an MRI-guided biopsy, which may indeed show multifocal or multicentric disease. Breast MRI can be helpful also in seeing if lymph nodes inside the chest, in the axillary area, and in the base of the neck are grossly involved, because that may then result in a ultrasound-guided biopsy to see if the patient already has metastases to lymph nodes. Other roles for breast MRI in the whole process is the follow-up imaging of patients who have had locally advanced breast cancer, stage 3 breast cancers, where after all of their treatments, particularly including even mastectomy and reconstruction, the breast MRI may be very important to us in detecting recurrent disease. And typically in that situation, the insurance companies will cover that. Finally, concerning whether the insurance companies will cover the cost of breast MRI, as far as follow-up, we know that in breast cancer, in BRCA1 and BRCA2 gene-positive patients, MRI is part of the annual screening process, and also in patients who have a lifetime risk of breast cancer greater than about 22 to 23%. So hopefully this gives you an overview again on where breast MRI fits into the scheme of things in the treatment, diagnosis, and follow-up of breast cancer patients. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.